Hi, my name is Pavel, I make games, and I'm gonna show you how to create your own animator for spreadsheet-based animations. Alright, in the previous video we have got our animation data ready. We don't need this spreadsheet, so let's close it up. And let's set frames of gap to, let's say, 15. Now all we need to do is to create a new sprite animator, because in Unity there is a regular animator and our version will be working only with sprites. Click edit script to open it up. Inside we don't need those functions, so let's delete them. And instead we need a public sprite renderer. That's the component we use to display our sprites in the scene. And let's also create a public animation data called base animation. For now it's just a placeholder for something we will need in the future. But if you want to use it now, there will be a challenge for you. More about that in the end of this video. The script we're gonna write isn't going to work until we tell Unity that the sprite renderer we need is inside player body game object. I've also set a player idle as a base animation for the player, do not forget about it in the future. Anyway, let's make the script do something. We're gonna create a public iEnumerator play animation. We will need a animation data from the outside. Let's simply call it data. And let's add a safety line for waiting one frame. We need to make sure that we wait at least once in this coroutine. I've probably mentioned that in previous videos, but it's really something worth to remember. First of all, it would be good to know when to stop animating stuff, and we can tell that by using the amount of sprites we have in a given animation. That's why we need to find the length of our array of sprites. The whole animation will be happening in this while loop, and to keep track of it, we will need another variable which will be a step of it. And let's say we keep animating this as long as the step is less than sprite's amount. For example, for 5 frames in our animation, we will loop 5 times. Inside the animation, we will change the sprite, wait a little bit, and also check special conditions, and we will talk about those conditions in the next video. To reach the end of the animation eventually, we need to increase the I variable somehow every step. Oh, and if you'd like to have a little challenge, please pause this video and finish this coroutine. You don't need to care about the conditions for now, just make the player play the animation once. Remember that you need to start this coroutine somehow, and for testing purpose, you may use base animation variable. Good luck, have fun! Alright, and now let's see my way of doing it. We'll need a sprite renderer, and we will access its displayed sprite and change it to data.sprites with a index of i. You can use ++ to increase this variable after this line of code is done, and that way we will also complete the third task. As it comes to waiting, we could use this line of code which lets us wait one frame of the game, not the animation, but we would have to repeat it a lot of times. Because wait time in this program stays the same for every frame, the frame of animation, we can calculate it once and use it every time we change the frame of the animation. Let's create a new float variable and let it be data.framesofgap multiplied by animation data.targetFrameTime. That's how we get a time of the whole gap between frames. Now let's write a yield return new wait for seconds. And let's use wait time there. Now I'm gonna use debug.log, you don't need to do this, to show you that if we use 15 as a frames of gap and our target frame rate is 60, we will wait 1/4 of a second between animation frames, because 15 is 1/4 of 60. As it comes to starting this coroutine, let's go to the click manager and in the go to item function we will start it. To do this we will use start coroutine function. We will grab the player, access its sprite animation component with get component sprite animation, and there we will use a play animation coroutine. It needs a argument of type animation data, so let's think about that for a moment. Compared to other game objects, the player won't have only two options, staying idle and the reaction. She will be walking, picking up items, dancing and so on. For what I have planned, she is the only game object which has multiple animations. I think it's a good idea to create a special array for her animations somewhere. In bigger games, it's a better idea to create a more complex sprite animator, but we will just make it nice and easy. Let's go to the game manager and here let's create a public animation data called player animations. Of course, it will be an array because we have a lot of animations there. And that's the only time we use this for any game object. We don't want to make this game a mess, you know. Now we may put game manager inside the play animation and use its animation data. In Unity we will go to game manager and put there our two animations. Player idle and player walk. And player walk is the number 1. And that's why we use number 1 in the script. Alright, we are moving towards the plant, the animation is playing, only once for now, and we can see that we wait 1/4 of the second every frame. Alright, I will repeat everything to make it clear what is happening. As we go to item, we start a coroutine which is in our new script sprite animator. We store player animations inside the game manager because our player is complex. In this coroutine we check how many sprites we have to know when to stop. We also calculate the wait time based on the frames of gap we set for every animation, multiplied by a static target frame time. The target frame time is common for every animation. Inside the while loop, we change the sprite to the next one in animation data and wait a little bit. Alright, if you want to challenge yourself, try looping this animation and as we reach the target, change it to the base animation. You will probably need to modify the sprite animator, animation data and click manager. Good luck! My solution will be in the next video. Have a good day and see you soon!